This Yahoo was sent in by two different people, one of whom was Jacob Locker, one of whom was Jack Howard. I don't know how it happened. It's a mystical occurrence. But
are they working together?
I think that they fucking work together, except they were sent like days apart, so they probably found it together. And then Jack was like, "Yeah, let's wait until Tuesday to send this in," and then he fucking got the jump on it on Saturday. Anyway, thank you both. It's by Yahoo Answers user Manuel, who asks, "Is it okay to eat in the bathroom at McDonald's?" Hi. Hello. How are you? Whenever I go to McDonald's, I always eat in the bathroom. I've been doing this for 5 years now without a problem.
I think that saying without a problem is very generous.
It's, well, yeah, let's break that term down. Is like the fucking McDonald's bouncer is not going to kick the door in and be like, "I've been following your trail for 5 years. It goes straight from the fucking cash register to the bathroom, so it was not a very difficult trail to follow. But
you got to think, though, that if he's been going to the same McDonald's, that the cashiers are starting to talk.
Oh, I hope he's not going to... I hope nobody's going to the same McDonald's. Except for that dude in Super Size Me.
Oh, new guy, don't worry. That's just Bathroom Steve.
That dude in Super Size Me who's like, "I ate 5,000 Big Macs. I eat 6 a day." And it's like, that's great. But, like, can you do them at different McDonald's so they're not like, "Oh, here comes Big Mac Mac"? Because his name's Mac.
His name is also Mac.
His name is also Mac.
Can you?
And it's like, why wouldn't you just call him Big Mac if that's the case? But, anyway,
well, because he was actually very thin, if I remember correctly.
He was a thin man. He was fucking disgusting.
Can you imagine you're on a road trip, you park, you pull into a McDonald's, you run, you make a rush for the bathroom, promising yourself that you'll go back and buy a high C or something. You go to the bathroom, you open the stall door, and there's just this guy hunched over jamming chicken strips into his mouth.
Occupied
with flavor.
Is he voiding, though, while he eats, is the question.
I should hope not.
Have we ever told the corn cob story? I feel like we have to have told the corn cob story, because it's the best thing that's ever happened.
No, to my knowledge, we have not.
The perfect diagram of efficiency that is the corn cob story.
The corn cob story is... We were at a trailer park?
No. I think it's a trailer park campground.
It was a trailer park campground, which is like, I don't care how fucking temporary your stay is. You're living in a trailer park for the period that you were there. We were staying there with our cousins or uncles or... I think it was Tim and Tom, right? And so we were staying there, and we were walking the grounds, seeing the sights, checking out, scoping some Winnies. And we went to the bathroom, and it was one of those deplorable kinds of bathrooms with no doors on the stalls. So, like, those technically
aren't
even...
They're not bathrooms.
They're fucking temporary concentration camps that you can walk out of.
They're risky water fountains, as far as I'm concerned. There's nothing...
They're little public jails. And we walked in, and I was walking, you know, just checking to see if maybe one of these fucking stalls had a door on it, because it's 1999, and we're living in a civilized goddamn world. And kind of. I mean, we were in a trailer park. And walked by one stall, and I didn't look long, because it's like, I guess, a crime. But there was a little kid, I'd say half chubby. I mean, he was half fat. Not either party in this scenario was half fat. He was this half fat kid. He was sitting there taking a poop, and while he was taking a poop, he was also eating some corn on the cob. He was eating his corn on the cob while voiding. And I walked out and made a hand gesture to... I forget who was with me. I made a hand gesture like a fucking SWAT team. Like, I can't talk. I can't. I'm about to lose my fucking mind laughing. You need to go walk 8 feet in that direction and look westward. Turn your eyes westward towards...
Corn cob boy.
Turns corn cob boy. And then we will... I did a little loop with my finger to say we will do some recon later on this. We will get together and discuss it in a group.
Not now, though. For now, we're completely...
Not now. I need to be total silence.
We're deep within enemy territory.
I need you to walk there. I need it to be very clear that I did not say, "Hey, go check out this kid with no pants on."
You have to keep it totally cash.
You got to keep it cash. Turn. Say, "Oh, excuse me." Say, like, "Excuse me," or, How's that corn? Pretty good, I bet, since you couldn't fucking tear yourself away from it. Couldn't leave it on the picnic table. Go void. Go evacuate and then return to your biz.
There was a moment in this kid's life where he was eating corn, realized he needed to use the bathroom, and thought, well, I can't leave this
here. I get it. I mean, he buttered it, and once you butter it, it's like, that's your day.
Yeah.
That's your day until it's done. That's your day.
Have you ever thought about it from this kid's point of view? That maybe, like, Griffin's acknowledgement of him and, like, just the look on Griffin's face changed this kid's life?
Turned his life around. That kid grew up Steve Jobs. He grew up super fast.
He grew up Steve Jobs.
Uh-huh. Anyway,